Just give me a quick sound check, Lyndon.
No.
Okay, Aki Karim here, BBTV. I'm with Lyndon King Arthur. Who's that?
This is what I'm saying about you guys coming in my gym, chatting shit.
Okay. Right, like, yeah, you know what the funny thing is, Lyndon?
I didn't even know he was real.
Do you know what the funny thing is? You've done it dead quiet because he's right outside the door, innit?
Oh, I punch you then.
You've not done it loud because you know he'll come in here and bang you out.
These are the other ones. These are the ones. This is it.
Is he that blind? Yeah.
No, they're not. They're, this, these are not. These are just for show.
Yeah, know. Yeah. Because they got. Where do you get them? Bury New Road. Yeah, with the Tom Ford, didn't it?
Tom Ford. Yeah. Tom Scores.
Tom Scores from Bury New.
Tom Scores.
Lyndon, you have got a good jab, haven't you? I've just seen it there on the back. It is a good jab, isn't it? It is.
It's all right.
It's good.
It's all right.
What I like is when you're doing your jab drills, you was even doing them when you thought no one was watching. But I was watching with the camera. And there'll be a clip of it right now as we're speaking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Practicing.
Good performance last time. Joel McIntyre, very good performance. I know it's a bit a while ago, but you know, it's a good performance. I know people expected you to win.
Yeah.
Well, we expected you to win.
Yeah.
But you did it in good, very good style.
Yeah, Joel, I said this for years, I'm supposed to do that to the level I believe that I'm gonna be on. I should have been doing that to him. No disrespect to him. But I expected to do that. Maybe not in the second round, but I thought as soon as I catch him like clean enough, I will get him out of there.
Well, we did mention it before, like at the old marina, that you were putting the right hand in a lot more. Now going forward, that the fights at the level you're gonna be at, they're all tough fights now, basically, yeah. The rest of your full career.
Yeah.
Is that something we're going to see more of? We're going to see you bringing that right hand in a lot like you did back in the amateur days?
Yeah. I got complacent with using the jab a bit too much and just not throwing the right hand frequently as much as I should. I hit pretty hard with the right hand, so it should be coming into my arsenal a lot more.
You're now sort of at that level where you can't go drop down a level because, with complete respect as well, but when you drop down a level, you see what happens.
Yeah.
So now, really, the only way is up in that sense, you know. So when you look at that you know that every fight here on in is going to be a tough fight, how does that make you feel like about the rest of your career?
It's exciting. It is what it is. It's just what I'm in boxing for. It's what everyone's in boxing for, I suppose. Tough fights are always good. When you get to a certain level of boxing, no fight's going to be easy. Like even the ones that you suspect are going to be easy are not easy. That's where you make the mistakes. Boxing's hard enough as it is anyway, so no point worrying about it. It's just the sport that I chose, and it is what it is.
It is what it is. You said something interesting to me out there. You were talking about just sparring in general, and said that sometimes you spar, and people might ping you in sparring. But when you go into the ring, you just feel cool and calm and everything like that.
Yeah.
What's your views on how much punishment you should take in sparring? How many wars should you be having in sparring?
No, you shouldn't. I want to say ping me. I don't. It's very rarely I get pinged. But like a time you might be feeling shit in the gym, and you're doing sparring sessions. You have up and downs. You probably have worse spars in camp than you do out of camp, kind of thing. Well, again, it's boxing. You're taking less punishment as you can is probably the aim of the game. Don't get hit as less as you can. But it's boxing. You can't swim without getting wet, as the saying goes. You're gonna get hit sometimes, but just try and not get hit as much as you can.
Do you feel fresh? Do you feel like a fresh fighter? I mean,
yeah.
You've not been in like you know.
I've not really been in any wars. I've been beat once. I suppose it was a bit of a stupid for me to stand in front of Yard, but apart from that, I've not really been hit.
You seem like you're quite settled and happy with the new Wassermann Cup.
Yeah.
They seem to as well be pushing you, you know, which is what you've.
Yeah.
I'm not saying no one else hasn't, but I'm just saying this. It seems like it's a nice.
Oh yeah, 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 man. Like they are showing that. No, they're showing me, I said this from the last time, they're showing me love that I feel like I deserve, and they're giving it. And we're working good as the team. They want me to do well, and I want me to do well. So I don't think I can go wrong.
You've been telling me about the plans for your potential next fight. I won't actually say it just, obviously, blatantly, just in case it's not ready to be released from Wassermann, but it's a good fight.
Yeah.
It's for a good title, which will at least give you options going forward, yeah. but it's not an easy fight. We've just been looking at the guys, the footage of the guy.
Yeah.
He's a tough Argentinian guy, yeah. and he does look solid.
Yeah.
It's definitely not going to be easy.
No,
so when you look at an opponent like that and you think, you know what, I've got to gear up for this guy. This could be an attritional fight. This could be a war.
Yeah.
How did your mindset start to change? I know you're a laid-back guy, but do you start to like really zone in? I think you're quite laid-back.
Nah, it's a fight, isn't it? Boxing is what it is. We're going to get in there. Somebody will win and somebody will lose. My job is to not lose.
Is that your outlook on boxing then, really? Like, quite simple as that? Because that's refreshing, because really you're not overthinking it in that sense.
That's what it is. When it's all said and done, that's what it is. Yeah. Go in there, as long as we've all come out healthy, somebody's going to win and somebody's going to lose. The odd time you'll get a draw in a fight, but more time, 9 times out of 10, somebody's going to win and somebody's going to lose. You've got to try and be the winner.
I've noticed that a lot more people interact with you on the social media world. I know before, back in the day, you was never
everyone
really big on it.
Everyone thinks I'm moody, but I'm not.
You're not. No, you're not. Well, you can be.
I can be a cunt.
Yeah. Mm. That can be the headline title of the video.
It can be. Nah, but you get whatever mood I'm in at the time when you see me. If I'm in a happy mood, I'll laugh. If I'm not, I won't. And that's just it, isn't it?
I watched a video. It was you, Zelfa, Sonny, Harley Ben. Yeah.
Harley shitbag Ben.
Well, I just watched, I was thinking, it just popped up literally on my Instagram, you know, all these things pop up, yeah. popped up, and I was like, oh, it's Lyndon, it's Elfa. Right, so I watched it, and it honestly had me crying with laughter. That was a side of you which I know I've seen before, but I think other people saw it, but that looked like quite a fun thing. Like, yeah. where did that come from?
You know what, me and Sonny just started doing lives, and people like me and Sonny as a duo kind of thing. They just take to us, we bounce off each other. And we come because we look so opposite. People kind of like, I think it's funny because Sonny's so little and he's white and I'm big and I'm mixed race or black or whatever you want to call it. And we bounce with each other, obviously we're good friends. It just works, isn't it?
It's good. It's they're very entertaining to watch. Yeah. I think Sonny is one of the most feared men in boxing. We're talking about on the Twitter stage here as well. But he, people who get tangled with him, I've seen, he ties them up in knots.
I don't understand. You know what it is with Sonny? He gets so much hate, yeah. And I don't know if it's because he's little. It's just people, because he talks with a different accent. I don't know. People just don't like him, and I don't understand why.
I think he loves it.
Yeah.
I think he loves it.
He does. He does. Yeah, he's got so much time for it. As boxers, all we do is train and go home and rest. And when we're resting, we'll be on our phones chatting shit to people. So to chat shit to Sonny on Twitter, it's just because he's got too much time. And go through your whole, you find receipts of your whole family and put them on there. Pointless.
He's definitely in the top 5 most feared men, you know. Along with like the tie and booths and
some people try. Yeah. People try and then just quickly find out that it's pointless.
Let me just change tack slightly. I've got to ask you a couple of things that I do mean to ask you about. The first one I'm going to ask you about is Tommy Fury's fight with Jake Paul. Now, the reason I ask you is because Tommy did train here for about 6 months, I think it was.
Yeah.
He used to come down here, same as when I seen you boys, seen Tommy here, seen him working out with you lot. So, I know you weren't a sparring partner, but you've done a few bits with him, technical stuff. So you're a perfect person to ask. It's a lot of people in the boxing world are going against Tommy. Me personally, I think Tommy's going to win. But just tell us about what he was like as a stablemate, basically.
Oh yeah, this was years ago, so he's probably a completely different human being than he was probably 5-6 years ago, whenever it was. He's good. I tell you what, Tommy, he's probably one of the hardest, like. With the technique work, is probably the hardest person I've been punched off.
One of the hardest person, or the, did you say the hardest?
Yeah,
right, okay.
Yeah.
That's a big claim. So he's heavy handed?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was back then. I don't think much has changed, but back then he's definitely one of the hardest person I've probably been hit with doing technique. Right, you know when you block and you feel it on your arms?
Mm.
Yeah, it's probably. Yeah.
Fair
Strange power.
Mm. Okay. Now, a lot of boxing people I've spoke to, they are actually. They don't think it's going to be a walk in the park. They think it's going to be a tough fight, competitive fight. And a lot of them are saying that Jake Paul is improving.
Yeah. Yeah.
Would you go along with that? Say that
I think he's improving. I don't think the fight's going to be as easy as what people are making out. I feel like there's a lot of pressure being put on Tommy, that like, unnecessary.
But, in which sense,
like in his dad saying and Tyson saying, if you don't beat him, you're fumbling your name and you can't be like he's 22 years old. Like, and I know, like, because everyone's saying Jake Paul's a YouTube boxer and that, like, he's no matter what you want to call him, he's been putting work in. Tommy should beat him. Tommy's like, on paper, Tommy should go in there and wipe him out. Because he's not, yeah, but I do think it's going to be hard, a harder fight.
The pressure thing.
I think when you get in there with Jake Paul and you realize that he's not as going to be easy to take him out, you hit him and he might stay there or he hits you back, and I don't think it's going to be as easy as what he thinks. But he should do it. Tommy should beat him.
You know, you've been on the big stage. You know about pressure. This is probably, well, this is Tommy's biggest fight.
This is what I'm saying. Even down to my fight, like, this is a bigger pressure fight for Tommy than any of my fights I've ever been in. Because, I mean, it's not a title fight. It's not 12 rounds, but it's a fucking big fight. It's pay-per-view event. It's a main event. You're up against a guy that's going to chat so much shit to you. Yeah, you've got the... If Tommy loses this fight, everyone for the rest of his life, he's going to beat off Jake Paul, who is a YouTube fighter. I don't think he is anymore, but he's going to say, everyone in boxing says he's a YouTube fighter. You've said you're going to knock him out. He's added pressure. If he performs under pressure, fair play to him. Putting the pressure on himself, good, but him losing to Jake Paul is mad.
Has he got to do it for boxing?
See, I'm not with all that Jake Paul's not a fighter anymore.
Okay, okay.
But to me, like, the one's 6-0, one's 8-0, or 5-0, whatever. Just Tommy should do it. Tommy should. And he should beat him. He should beat him. I just don't think it's going to be as easy as... But I got my last boxing prediction wrong, so...
Who's your last prediction on?
Liam Smith. And...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I seen it. Yeah, you're all jumping off to the right, weren't you? I told everyone Liam's going to win
But even at the show, yeah, someone asked me, like, one of the interviewers or one of the guys said, "Would you have a prediction?" And about 10 minutes before the fight, I said, "Yeah, I think Eubank's going to be a bit too big, bit too fast, bit too fat, Roche ferocious." And he got smacked off.
I saw your reaction afterwards because Jonathan filmed it.
I was in shock. Couldn't believe it. But I don't think no one could in the crowd. Like, even if you thought Yves Smith was going to win.
Yeah, yeah. Nobody
put him to win in the first four rounds.
I spoke to only one person who said that was going to happen. No one else did. Yeah.
Knock him out.
Yeah, I spoke who to one that? Person. His name's Peter. He did a prediction for me. And he said, Peter McDonough is a boxer.
Oh, Peter McDonough. Yeah,
he done a prediction and he said he's going to get knocked out. Everyone ridiculed him, took the piss out of him. And it happened. So
yeah, because it's a big shock in boxing. It is a big shock. Not a big shock in the aspect of Liam Smith should never been able to do that, because Liam Smith's a fucking world-class fighter. Like, and people, you know what it was with me in that fight, yeah? I just bought, yeah, like an idiot, yeah? I bought into the Eubank, like, confidence. Like, when I'm watching it, and I'm watching him, and you do kind of think that Smith was a bit riled up by him, and you do kind of think the saute, I'm going to... How confident Eubank was, yeah, made me believe, nah, there's no way you can get beat. There's no way you can chat that much shit and get beat like that. Yeah. Like, and get knocked out and do this stinky leg. There's no way Liam Smith's gonna make you do any of that. Yeah, that because of the confidence he had, and I kind of bought into that like an idiot, forgetting that Liam Smith has only been beat up Canelo really, kind of thing.
Yeah,
and then
Munguia, but that was again
a close fight. And the other guy
who we actually beat. Yeah, no, I thought Liam.
A lot of people say he beat. So, and Liam Smith's a fucking world class operator, and everyone that sparred him or that spoke to or that speak about him say he's probably the best Smith, like, technically and stuff like that. So I just kind of let that slip my mind and forgot that because of the way Eubank was, just carries himself. And he's never been stopped. And he's got the chin and he's the bravado of the and all that shit. You don't think he's going to lose kind of thing. Even though he's been beat, anytime Eubank stepped up to a higher level, he's been beat. And you forgot that as well because he talked that much shit about sauteing. Man,
I've heard you say that before, Fat. You said you were going the little salt bait. I've seen you do that.
So you bank copied me.
There you go.
Know what you're saying? Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
Nah, but yeah. Yeah. That's what I mean, man. Like, so, you know, I stand corrected in that.
Fair enough. So, at least you're big enough to acknowledge it.
I was a fool in that.
Are you big enough to acknowledge that Yard did well enough against Better BF?
Did what?
Did quite well against Better BF.
He did all right. You can't look. No, you can't take away from him that he didn't do all right. But I just feel like it was always nothing. And that's not even being a hater. Not because he's competition, like whatever. Like I'm not even like a hate on the hating side of things. I just think like that was gonna happen. But take nothing away from that. It's not a shit world champion. It's a Better BF. Like, he beats everyone and he knocks everyone out. So the fact that you got knocked out, that he got knocked out by him, sorry, it's not shameful. It just like when people do better, a little bit better than they should have done. It kind of looks like they did better than they did. But I don't think Better BF was ever in any trouble. I think when he got hit with a right hander too, he took a walk, went for a walk. He's very clever. Better BF is a lot cleverer than people think. He's not just a brawling boxer kind of thing.
But, you know, very systematic and
methodical. Yeah. He knew when he got hit to take a walk for a minute, come back, get the round back. Yeah. Like I don't know how people had Yard up on the scorecards, but I don't know, it was a good fight to watch. It was entertaining. It was a little bit back. It was competitive at some parts of the fight. Better BF's a monster.
Why don't we get all the light heavyweights in England and have a tournament?
I'd do that. It's the
sixth division.
To put it together.
Okay, well let's tell them. Well, I'm going to tag out every one of them in. Frank, Eddie Hearn, Kale, Nisa. Tag them all in.
Yeah.
Would you enter it? Would you be up for it?
Facts.
Yeah. It'd be sick though, wouldn't it?
Yeah, of course.
It'd be sick. Look at the talent, man. Look at, and it's all domestic. We don't have to go nowhere.
Loads of us.
Could have
loads of us.
We don't have to travel.
Loads of us.
Yeah.
Like a Super Six.
Yeah, like a Super Six, man. Get it on.
You haven't done that. The Super Six was sick. They did Muhammad Ali tournament. That was
sick. That was to Saulins again. Yeah, they did that. And I went to them. They were brilliant.
Yeah.
So why not? Why don't we do it, man? So surely a promoter can see the depth. But then again, it's promoters just don't work with each other, really. No. But I do know that Kale does, and you know,
and Kale does.
He put on that tournament.
Definitely exciting. But the light heavyweight scene is exciting right now, isn't it? It's exciting. There's so many fights to be made.
There's loads of fights to be made. Go on, tell me on a closing thing then. Just tell me the one fight you'd love to see in your own division.
Without me in it?
Yeah, just whatever, yeah. Or without you?
Bivol and Better BF.
Bivol and Better BF, yeah.
Yeah.
And you think Bivol wins that, don't you?
I do, yeah. Mm. Yeah, but in a grueling fight. Mm. I think Bivol's distance and Bivol's footwork and... But then that's taken... Yeah, it's a good fight. It's a good fight. I just...
Good fight.
I had 64 in favour of Bivol.
Domestically?
That's
the fight that you'd like most like to see in your division that you're not involved, just as a spectator that you're not involved with.
Callum Smith and Boatse.
Oh yeah, that's a good fight that. Very good fight.
Yeah, Callum Smith and Boatse.
Yeah. Okay.
I'd like to, because them boys are both good at block and countering. And I think they stay in the pocket with each other. That'd make a good fight for television.
Yeah.
As a spectator, you said so.
Yeah. Wow. You answered it spot on there. Yeah, you took the brief. You thought about the brief and you delivered, in The Apprentice. Yeah. Well done.
That'll be a good fight to watch.
Yeah. All right. Cool. Well, look, Lyndon, hopefully you'll get it. Well, there'll be an announcement sometime about this next upcoming fight, but it's good to see you going in that right direction. Yeah. And it's going to be a good thing to watch. What are you doing the rest of the day?
Going to play football with my son.
Nice. Good. Keep him away from boxing.
Yeah. Foot boxing. You know what? I don't let my son box. From a young, I made him southpaw anyway. Yeah. But if my son is, he has to be at elite level. Oh. I have to see
for you to allow him to continue to the
like,
path.
Yeah. All right, yeah, I'm gonna support this.
Yeah,
I don't want him to box.
Yeah,
boxing's a horrible sport, man. It's horrible. It's grueling. It's it's good when you're at the top. Not that I'm saying I've been there, but it's good. I'm even fighters I've seen like it's good when you're at there, but then. Like now, Anthony Joshua. Yeah. This is my dear. Anthony Joshua has been beat off Usyk. Yeah, it's finished. Yeah, it's got beat off Berbia, but the people are saying he's gonna be a world champion. Mm. But Anthony Joshua was finished because he got beat off Usyk.
Yeah,
that's how much sport is.
It's a fair point. Yeah,
it's crazy. You lose one fight and you're the worst. It's just horrible. I've been on the end of it. Yeah. And I've been on the other end of it. When I beat y'all, I was the best friend ever. When I got beat off y'all, he's the shit. It's shit. But that happens to every boxer. Any boxer that gets beat is finished. It's finished. And you see it, fan, and you know what? And that's because the internet. The internet's a scary place. And if you're not strong minded, it will fuck you up. Because no matter how many messages you get or comments you see of people. Get out of our interview.
You're getting off.
I dare you interrupt.
You're getting off.
Yeah, I'm getting off.
Okay, I'm gonna come see you next week.
That's what I mean.
I'm gonna come see you next
this
week.
That's what I mean.
Yes, he didn't know the camera was on. Yes, I've got it as well. I got it.
Yeah, you see my wife and kids. You know? Put it back on. Put it back.
Yo, are you
nah.
Nah.
That was brilliant. Nah. I caught Pat slipping.
You get it.
Oh yeah, did you see it?
Baby girl, buddy.
Why'd you wait for the door to shut before you said it?
Nah, but I didn't know. Oh yeah. But yeah, boxing fans are horrible, man. Dude, boxing fans are good when it's going good, but then
yeah,
they're not when it's going bad. They're not, and it's hard. It can be horrible for you. It can be horrible. Like, I had somebody in my DMs the other day. Yeah, and more time I don't even go through my DMs, but the other time when I get bored, I go.
Yeah, don't even go through them.
Yo, this guy was slating me. Yeah, I swear to them, I was laughing. It's funny, but yo, this guy was chatting. I mean, paragraphs of shit to me, yeah. So I was reading it, I was thinking, yo. So I messaged him back, I'm like, bro, have I banged your girlfriend? So like, have I slept with you? Have I messaged your girlfriend? Well, like,
and he said, yeah.
Is everything not? No, but he don't do that on the camera. Nah, and he's like, he's ignoring what I'm saying, and he's just slating me again, chatting shit. Anyway, I just said, yo, get help. Just get the help you need, innit? Yeah. Safe, bro. Thank you. See you
there. There you go. People.
Everyone thinks Pat's the boss. Yeah.
They're coming, bringing you water. Yeah.
But anyway.
So this guy.
My man was. I mean, paragraphs of shit. Yeah. 3 days later, he come back and apologized. Yo, I'm sorry for that. I think he must have been drunk or something. Yeah. He's like, I'm sorry. I was going through a rough time. Blah blah blah. I should never have done it. I apologize. And I was like. Why?
But
why?
It does.
And I'm not even on a high level of person yet.
Yeah.
So I just imagine what you Kanye West and you Kim Kardashian. Yeah, you know what I mean?
They shouldn't even look at their DMs.
Yeah. But my point is, like every good message you get, you read and you be like, yeah, sick. But every bad message you get, you be like, nah, is that why? Is that me? Is that what I do? You know what I mean?
I seen the same thing with Elfra after Kiko Martinez. Yeah, I seen the same. He showed me his phone the Tuesday after when I come to see him more. Yeah,
people would be horrible.
Horrible, man. Horrible.
It's what we're in. We're in the public
eye. Yeah, you are. But
we're in the public eye, so no, you give them.
You expect it, but you shouldn't. You don't deserve it.
Deserve it, but a lot of people don't deserve it. No, kids don't deserve cancer. Like, yeah. You know what I mean? Like it's so minor on the scale of things, but. My point is, if you're not strong-minded, it can fuck you. Not just in boxing, the social media as a whole, it's a scary place.
When you've retired, we'll go through the DMs and have a look at some of the messages and everything. But it's a dark world, man.
Yeah, it is. Very, very.
It's good to know that you're mentally strong enough to and, you know, because I have seen some fighters serious enough. I've seen it first.
Can get you down. Not me, but I mean, like, I imagine it can get you down if you like Conor Benn, no? I imagine his DMs are horrid.
Oh yeah, I bet they are. Well, I know they are facts. I know someone who told me.
Horrid.
Yeah.
Horrid. But just before this, I know. If he's done it, it's bad. Probably people are wishing him death in his DMs and all that.
Oh yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
They have been.
But I don't understand people like that, because I think, like, all right, you've typed the bad shit, yeah. Then you've sent it. So you've sent it. Now you've got time to unsend it, yeah. But you've sat there, you've typed it, you've composed this message and you've sent it. You're probably saying nigga, blah, blah, this, you did die this and die that. And you've sent it and you've left it there. And in your head, you think you've done something good.
Very strange mentality.
I've never understood it.
Yeah, I've never.
People make fake accounts to slate people. Mm. I've never ever understood why people do it.
It's
ever.
Embarrassing. Really.
I for the life of me, I cannot understand why you believe that making a fake profile, going on your fake profile and chatting shit about this is off topic completely. But Steve-O the Madman is an influencer type guy. He's on Snapchat. He's so many followers on Snapchat. Whatever. He's famous, so to speak. Sometimes he goes through his Snapchat share and he'll put out what people send him. People say shit about his children.
Shocking.
His kids are kids.
Shocking.
13, 12, baby girl, 5 or whatever. And they say shit about his children. Nigga this. I'm going to do this to your daughter and blah, blah. And it's like, don't get the word. Like, I don't get it. I don't get it. I don't understand why people are like that. It's just shit though. Like, it's not even cool.
No.
It's not. At no point can your friends think, oh, do you go to your friends and go check what I sent this person or that person? It's like, what are you going through in your life to think putting other people down and saying derogatory shit about people is fucking good?
Yeah. I fully agree with you.
It's just dead. That's totally off topic.
No, it's a good insight.
I was talking about that, it's like,
yeah.
I can't get my head around it.
I'm glad you mentioned it, because at least young fighters listen to this, know to brace themselves.
Yeah. If you're upcoming, like, they expect it. Upcoming, yeah. Anything, not even fighters.
Anything,
fuck what people say.
Yeah.
And fuck what people do, bullies and all that shit. I just don't understand it. Don't get it in life. It's just like, the world's fucked up enough as it is. Do you know what I mean? Like, the world is a fucked up place.
Yeah.
Like, completely fucked up. To the point we don't even know how fucked up it is.
Yeah.
But like, then you get these other people that are doing extra shit. You've been messaging people and being racist and saying fucking this and that about people's children. It's just mad.
Mm-hmm. No, you're right, London. It is. It's mad. And it's a sad, sad world at times. But it's good that you've got the right mindset for it. That's for sure.
You have to, because like I said, it can really fuck you if you're not.
All right, man. I think that's actually the longest.
I went off topic.
No,
it's totally
good.
There,
I think that's. I would say that's the best interview we've done.
You say that every time you do an interview.
The last three times, because the last three probably have been. There you go. Back in the day, you used to give me one word answers on purpose. All right, Lyndon. All the best, and looking forward to the announcement on your next fight. And all the best, man.
Yeah.